Africa on the move. Stories about people making a difference, shaping their nation and their continent. Africa on the move. Stories about motivational changemakers taking their destinies into their own hands. DW's new multimedia series for Africa. DW.com, Africa on the move.
AIT, sharing the African experience.
I'm very happy that I was able to come here this morning to see the very popular Apo Karishi Road under construction, which everybody has been telling me is going to be the solution to reduce the traffic gridlock on the Nyanya Maraba axis. Of course, you have all seen what we have seen. What we just saw is a strip of asphalt from nowhere to nowhere, basically. And what we have seen is a sign of what has been very wrong with us as a people. It's also a sign of disappointment of us all, really. Because quite frankly, I simply cannot understand how it will take us, that is the FCT administration, the entire engineers in the FCT administration, and a contractor that prides himself to be one of the up-and-coming local contractors, how it will take us 4 good years to construct only 10 kilometers of road. This is absolutely amazing.
Minister of the Federal Capital Territory Abuja, Mohammed Bello, in January 2016, during his first visit to some sections of the Apo Karishi Road project on the outskirts of the nation's capital, Abuja. His visit, which supposedly raised high hopes about the possible completion of the now 7-year-old road project, came barely 2 months after his appointment and assumption of office as Minister of the Territory. Unfortunately, it has been 1 whole year now and counting, with nothing having significantly changed after the celebrated visit of the minister to the abandoned 6.3 billion naira road project. I am TV Tia. Welcome to Straight Talk. On this edition of the program, we shall revisit the sad story of the 13.25 kilometer Apo Karishi Road project in the Federal Capital Territory, Abuja, which two successive FCT ministers, Bala Mohammed and now Mohammed Bello, have failed to complete in 7 years. Contract for the project was awarded in 2010 when Bala Mohammed was the FCT minister, and up till when he left office as the longest serving minister of the territory under democratic rule following the defeat of President Goodluck Jonathan in the 2015 general election, he continued to claim that the road was 65% completed even when the contract for some sections of the project had not even been considered to be awarded. and the contractor, even in January 2016, said the road was only 52% completed. But that may be history now, with all the controversies, inconsistencies, and allegations of corruption that have continued to trail the all-important road project, whose primary objective was to help ease the traffic gridlock on the Nyanya corridor of the Abuja-Kefi Expressway, which is now fast deteriorating to become the worst of all the three major highways leading in and out of the Nigerian capital, Abuja. For those who may not know, there are about 10 densely populated satellite towns and communities along the 24-kilometer Nyanya Karshi Road, including Nyanya, Jikwe, Kurudu, Orozo, and Karshi, amongst others, on the outskirts of the city center that feed the Abuja-Kefi Expressway with vehicular and human traffic that usually grounds movement on the expressway during the rush hours of the day. This avoidable and unfortunate situation makes matters worse for those living in Maraba and the adjoining neighborhoods and communities of Kabayi, Masaka, Waman Village, and a host of others in neighboring Nasarawa State, who also have no other alternative access to the nation's capital but the Abuja-Kefi Expressway. Instructively, this was what the FCT Minister Mohammed Bello captured aptly when he first visited the road project in January 2016 to inspect the construction work that was said to be in progress. Completion of the 13.25-kilometer road would be a signature project today for not just any minister of the territory, but the President Muhammad Buhari-led administration. However, this is what Mohammed Bello has failed to achieve in the last 1 year and counting. This was the hill and the point where construction of the road had stopped when we were here in January 2016 with the FCT Minister, Mohammed Bello. The contractor who was on site to receive the minister and his team was full of excuses as to why the all-important road project cannot be completed, in addition to revealing so much for the first time about the project that none of the civil servants the minister has now chosen to work with had told him as part of the briefing he received when he assumed office as minister.
There have been several challenges about this project in 2010, December 2010, and the rest in 2011. We had several challenges with respect to the road. We are doing a lot, we have not out to start, and now we have contact with the DSM talking about this project. The problem of the road is the road layout that we got. We don't have to blame the federal government for that, but we did it for it at that moment, and we are trying to do that to achieve it at that point. What is the challenge to us if we don't get paid on time to get the project to progress to the level that we want to progress to? And I think that the minister uses his powers to get us paid as a time to ready for someone to do the mission on the project. Because when we came into this project, it was deep goals that we did not we did it for cash year or not. We did not bid for this road, even as an addendum. And also big goals which we did not negotiate for. We are trying our best. One of the hills down there is about 500 meters. No, 50 meters. Up, and we have to cut it down without a complaint. We did not negotiate for that. We did not negotiate for some of the rocks that we are cutting. But be that as it may, we are Nigerians. We feel compelled as Nigerians to be on the road and complete the road for the federal government. We know the challenges that people are facing, both at that end and on this end. But one other thing that has happened, sir, is that the road we are taking from Kashiara access up to this point. And even if we finish the road up to this point, it's still not accessible from here to the road. To the main road is about 5 kilometers. The challenge, ES and I have had several discussions on this before. ES has offered us to do this project, this part of the road, at the rate we are doing here. But sir, honestly, the rate we are doing here, we are doing it at no profit at all. We are just doing it because it's the first project we got in Abuja, and we feel committed to achieve it, to accomplish it for government. In spite of the payments that we have not got, at a particular point in time, the Shopee took over this road, so they were unable to help SCDA to pay, even when they budgeted about $2 billion for this road. SCDA did not get a cover out of that Shopee, so SCDA had to show it by themselves. So we actually need also to look at the access road to the area people will be able to have access when this road is completed.
I have heard from the contractor and I have heard from our citizens in this beautiful village and all the villages along the road. And I have also heard from the FCTA engineers handling this project. And I weep. For instance, it now occurred to me, based on the explanation, that this contract was even awarded to a contractor that was not even willing to do the job. Apparently, this is not his primary work. His work was supposed to be Karshi Ara Road. And they just gave him this contract, which he reluctantly accepted. And also, apparently, they gave him a road that was not even well designed. And then the entire structure decided to award a contract on a road that will just be hanging. Because how could you say you are constructing a road from Karshi to Apo and you just do it halfway without even thinking and even awarding the linkage between Apo to this place we are here? If all the traffic is routed from Karshi and they decide to come here, for God's sake, how are they going to enter the city? So this is a big embarrassment and it's a shame to us, all of us. Before I came in here, I made some inquiries on the contracting firm. And I have received a lot of complaints about this particular company. I understand they are doing about two districts. One in the city, another one also, I understand, in one of the districts on the way to the airport. If this is a company that will build 9 point something kilometers in 4 years, I don't know how they have the capacity to continue all the existing contracts. But it is the policy of this government to enhance local capacity. But definitely, if this is what local capacity means, then we better bring in people from elsewhere to come and do our work for us, and we go home and weep in shame to show that we have no capacity. But having said that, since the contractor is complaining of payment, and I've looked at the figures and I've seen the outstanding payments, by the grace of God, we'll try to make payments as quickly as possible so that work can continue here. But I'm giving the contractor the option. If you find that this project was given to you as a mistake, or you think you are doing a favor for anybody for taking this project, please just stop it. We cancel it. We get somebody. Go ahead and continue your project on the Karshi, or what do you call Karshi? Ara Road, if that is what you want to do. And then we'll get somebody competent to do this. But if you sit down with your engineers and you decide you want to do this project, we are going to give you payment. But quite frankly, the figures I have seen for 13 kilometer road, may God forgive all of us.
By July of 2016, we were told payment had already been made to the contractor to continue work, but with no action, however, taken on the other weighty issues raised by the contractor, including the clear instances of corruption which the minister himself identified while responding to what the contractor had told him and his team. When we visited the project site 6 months after the inspection by the FCTA minister, Only a few more kilometers had been constructed after the hill the minister saw had been brought down, with no staff of the construction company on site. Already the road had again been abandoned when, out of curiosity to see what was beyond the point where work had stopped, we made an exhausting footwalk through a bush path to negotiate the valley and another hill that was standing before us. And having negotiated to the other side of the hill, this is what we saw. A very old and perhaps poorly executed attempt at pulling down the hill to make a path, but obviously showing also that there is so much work that needs to be done. And then you can see also that the villagers have made attempts at finding their way through, and ahead of us is a very thick vegetation that also shows that a lot of work also needs to be done to get this job ready for motorists and residents of Abuja to enjoy this part of the city. This is the very difficult and rough terrain that we had to follow the last time we were on this road. This time around, we've made arrangements for motorcycles, but then it's very clear also that even the use of motorcycles and this part of the road has its own challenges. We were indeed lucky to ride safely through the slopey bush path, as hundreds have over the decades not been so lucky. This is 4-year-old Babayo Jika with a fracture on his left hand. He fell off the motorcycle while being transported across the jungle here with his family members. Babayo is only one out of four other unlucky persons we met undergoing traditional treatment for different fractures and dislocations they sustained while using the abandoned road. They have opted for the unreliable services of traditional bone setters because they are obviously too poor to afford hospital bills. The cost of the corruption trailing the abandoned road project is enormous. This is a man in his mid-40s. He also broke one of his legs after falling off the motorcycle he was riding on, the same abandoned road project. And his story is that of how his children may not go back to school in 2017.
When did this happen?
Around Monday, and as I should get Christmas, 2016. The nurse, yeah, the nurse has that now. Somebody
now farmer, but when you get this accident, you know they go farm in yam, corn, cotton, something like this. You know if you carry them come house, now people they help them, but now they give them money. But up to now, you know the. If the left kid, if you get the normally missing, go house and the me in the checking farm. Now you know you can get working with the control to your family. This is the problem.
So the man kuma sabo da akoya runa gudada wanda then show gudabu no.
He just two boys for house. Their school is Napusi. The guys don't come out. No money. They see how in there. They won't be going back to school. No money. If they pray, make them finish because maybe everything will be normal.
For this man, the only hospital that could possibly have been of help to him and little Babayo is this primary healthcare center constructed under the defunct subsidy reinvestment and empowerment program SHORPE, introduced by the President Goodluck Jonathan administration after the 2012 New Year fuel price hike. We could not have access into the health facility, but we are told the needed beds, mattresses and hospital equipment have been provided, but the health center has remained under lock and key because with the non-completion of the road in the area, no staff has been posted to work there. Since its completion, the primary health care center has been taken over by overgrown grasses, with fire remaining a potent threat to the entire facility, especially during the dry season. As we speak, all the communities along the abandoned 13.25 kilometer Apo Kashi Road depend on one drugstore run by this nurse, Destiny Enenche, who moved into the area only in 2015.
I met this structure like this, and since then it has been like that. Since I came in, I've been able to render medical service to them at my level. But in most critical cases, because there is no hospital around here, they do go to either Kerishi or Kabusa. That is where they go for critical cases. But if anything that has to do with labor and other things, though my business is not a government, it's non-governmental, and you know, when it has to do with government, it will be of more help to them because the charges will be lesser and all that. But in a situation whereby, in the case of critical case, you have to rush them down to Kerishi, they are all farmers here. They are finding it tough. Like, if you want to go to Kerishi now, Okada will ask you to pay a 500 naira. If it has to do with critical case, now that it will be charged more higher. And that, most people here, they are farmers, and they for them to afford that kind of money is not easy. But if with the road, with the help of the road, I think it would be more easier. With 50 naira you are there, or 100 naira you are there. But in a case whereby the road is bad, you know, they'll be thinking of how to pay the hospital bill at the same time, thinking of how to transport their people down there. So it's not really easy at all.
What kind of diseases, what are the most common diseases?
The common disease people come for here is malaria and typhoid, because they don't have good water, source of water here, and they are exposed to this plasmodium here, so they normally come with cases of malaria and typhoid. And one other thing I noticed in the majority of people here, they do complain of gastric and duodenal ulcers, because they do over-the-counter drugs, they administer drugs to themselves without proper prescription, you know. And we are made to understand that all these non-steroidant analgesic anti-inflammatory drugs, they are capable of they serve as predisposing factor to ulcer.
Now, back to the road project itself. Authorities say 9.8 kilometers of the 13.25 kilometer road have been constructed. This simply means 3.45 kilometers of the road could not be constructed in more than 1 year that Mohammed Bello has served as Minister of the Federal Capital Territory. We have requested for an interview with the minister on several occasions, even in writing, but he does not seem disposed to talking to us, not just about the Apo Kashi Road project, but several other topical issues in the territory. However, let's listen to the FCT Minister Mohammed Bello on his impression of the abandoned road project in January, as of January 2016.
Quite frankly, the figures I have seen for 13 kilometer road, may God forgive all of us. Let's call the director in charge of this project to tell us the figure for the contract, how much has been paid, and what is the outstanding. And then I leave all of you to judge whether the figure paid and the work done is commensurate.
Thank you, Minister.
The contract, Mr. Park, they are in two, the Karishi Ara and the extension of Karishi Abu. About 6.4 billion for the two projects, and the total amount of 10.3 billion has been paid.
Is it Naira?
In Naira, has been paid up to today. That is for up to certificate 1 to 4 that have been raised. But a balance of 345 million. The last certificate is the one that is outstanding now. Thank you very much.
The failure of the FCT minister to take the appropriate action to address the clear instances of corruption, even when he personally acknowledged that the total of 6.3 billion naira being the contract sum for the road project was too high for the construction of the 13.25 kilometer road in a place like the Federal Capital Territory, only but instructively points to the fact that there is still a long way to getting the abandoned Apokarishi Road project completed. Another fraudulent thing about the road project was the award of the contract without an engineering design, which till date may not have been produced by the Federal Capital Development Authority, FCDA, that has taken over the project from the Satellite Towns Development Department of the FCT administration.
Yeah, I know that the minister did talk about engineering design, but I will not be able to say categorically what is the position as it is now. But I am sure that if the project is progressing, then it means the right thing must have been done for the road to progress. If not, probably they would have ordered that the contract should be terminated. But if it is still going on, I should assume that maybe whatever mistakes were done must have been corrected.
It was brought under the purview of FCDA because the level that we need to go into, we require the law to back us up. But the law that should facilitate the workings of STDA is before the House of Assembly. It has gone through first reading, it has gone through second reading, and it's supposed to go for a public hearing soon. Some things are not possible to do if there is no law backing. It will become illegal, an illegal thing. That is to answer the fact that it is not because of incompetence. All the engineers from Satellite Towns are brought up by the FCDA. All of them passed through the system before they were sent to Satellite Towns. So they are offspring of FCDA. Also, the reason for what you said that is a poor quality of work, the reason is actually that the standard of work by law in the Satellite Towns, the standard of work is slightly lower. It is done not because the needs are lower capacity, but as you will imagine, the Satellite Towns cover a large area, and if you have tried going on the pit, there are so many rules that require attention. It is very, very capital intensive.
The absence of an engineering design means that the contractor can do anything he so wishes with the road project, including the quality of work and the provision of facilities along the road infrastructure. This much the contractor took advantage of, as can be seen along the road, especially along the abandoned sections. For instance, there are a number of these culverts along the road which were constructed in place of constructing proper bridges. The waterways have been effectively blocked with the narrow culverts and even sand in some worst cases. These are clearly potent threats to the durability of the road if it is eventually ever completed. And then the quality of the other sections of the road that have been reportedly completed are also raising concerns even before the road is formally put to use. The project is without drainage, and worse still, the non-construction of walkways makes the size of the road ridiculously small, with fears that it may not serve the high volume of traffic expected on it even before the expected public outcry for expansion of the road if it is ever completed.
Muna bukata nace ina muna bukata budo muna hanyi ni kwadi saboda
the road is too small. It's like an only people there, the influencer, no gutter, no the road, no slow. So if rain come, those would enter the road, but make them do the water. If rain fall, water would they follow the water. This is the problem. The prayer made them open the road.
I once had interaction with one of the worker. I told him that this place is too, the road is too small. If you start tripping on the road now, the road that is still on, under construction, if you start walking down now, you see potholes everywhere. You see, the road that is still under construction and there are potholes, what will happen by the time they are done with the road? You see, so I don't think they are using quality material as well. So if there's anything that government, as for me, I even suggest that if they cannot handle it, let foreign contractors take over so that they can be of help to us. Because like this hill now, if it is white men that is handling this place now, that will be the big, that place will be more beautiful than any part of the road. Because the way they will take their time to construct it, if you look at it, you will like it very well. So if they cannot handle it, government should just bring in other manpowers that can handle it effectively. The way they are doing it, they are not using quality material to construct the road, and yet they keep saying money is not released. How can somebody that is giving you contract, he knows nothing about the road, he doesn't know how much it will cost him, and that is why he's giving you the room to give quotation. So for you now to say it's the SDLA that gave us quotation, they are the people that made us not to construct it the way we want it, I don't think is a good idea. It's not an excuse.
So you also have fears that even if the road eventually is finished, there might be challenges or one or two, a year or two failed portion.
Yes, that is what I'm saying. Like if you walk down a little, there's one culvert there. You see, it's very tiny. It's not even, there's not some, like now, they are not done with it yet. If you see, now, this asphalt, what is it called? This is sand. They fill the place. Now, because of the rain, it's already breaking. So if they had put this final level now, I believe it would have done the same thing.
All those things, where did they talk? Everybody just they talking on. But the road, the normal road, where did they do so? The one way they don't produce now, do come. And they see the road. It's just the type of the measurement for the road. They did the same thing with the remaining road, where did they do? I don't see differences. All those things now, everywhere they talking on mountain.
Shem Adamu has been employed to work on the road project, and he drives one of these heavy-duty vehicles. This is perhaps the very first time he is being involved in the construction of a road, with many of his likes recruited from the villages located along the road by the contractor, who did not hire professionals to do the job just to be able to save costs and make more profit at the expense of public good.
the roads na big roads, everybody they follow this road, but as a the problem come come for the federal government where they come do changing. They change you come come now the money we get for the contract, they no agree release the money. You now I get for almost 5 months now no paying salary. No money. Say Oga, they tell us they already blocked the account. To where they release money for the contract, I beg, make them finish this contract, because this road now, many people they suffer for this road. As for me, where are they? The road, if I talk how I don't talk, suffer for the road, not be small. When I saw other people, many motor for the past year, they go inside town easily. But now, because they never finish the work. Now, everybody there now, everybody they suffer for the road. Some people, they come here to do better something here. No way, because no road. I beg me, at the Bay Federal Government, make them try, release money for this man, make this man finish a project. Now, only my talk, where I get with that. The road by themselves. The road, they go check how the road there, because this place where they so hill, many hill there for the road. Especially hill where there for the Karshi site here now, big hill. The town where they give the contract, they don't say the hill there like that. Now where the hill don't come now, come there now, the work where they do there, make they add money for them so that when they complete the work, now you hold the work so. Kuma na only that here now, now be the work for the road now. From the remaining work, not any work again. But the only he made the least money for the he made the man finish the contract. Now be the problem for the road. But for the other place, no any big work again.
The absence of an engineering design for the road project has given birth to the poor quality of work on the ground. But it must be said that the abandoned Apo Karshi Road project has perhaps seen the worst of supervision of such a multi-billion naira public project. And it is only fair that the public officers who have so failed to protect public interests in the last several years and counting should indeed be held accountable. The story of the seven-year-old Apo Karshi Road is clearly that of public servant colluding with the construction company that did not even bid for the project and then allowing him to do whatever he so pleases with the road project in the name of construction. Other public officers who have failed in the supervision of the abandoned road project are members of the standing committees on the Federal Capital Territory in the Nigerian Senate and the House of Representatives, which alone has two committees on the FCT just to be able to create portfolios for the lawmakers. The Senate Committee on the FCT, chaired by Dino Melaye, takes delight in once in a while making loud noise about projects in the city center when the members drive in the comfort of air-conditioned vehicles to conduct their supposed oversight functions. The worst case is that of the committee on the FCT in the House of Representatives, chaired by Hembe, and the committee on the area councils and auxiliary matters, chaired by Zephaniah Jisalu, who himself is the House member representing the Amagbuari Federal Constituency, where the abandoned road project is located. It is a sad commentary that none of these committees has ever visited the abandoned Apo Karshi Road project. And the National Assembly, which is constitutionally the House of Assembly for the Federal Capital Territory, has failed over the years to effectively play this critical role through the instrumentality of its standing committees. And this only gives credence to the argument of those advocating for the establishment of the office of a mayor and legislative council for the Federal Capital Territory as a second tier of government to take issues of governance more seriously in the nation's capital. Another issue thrown up by the lack of an engineering design for the road project was captured by the FCT Minister Mohammed Bello himself in January 2016 when he visited the road project. Let's now listen to him.
Of course, you have all seen what we have seen. What we just saw is a strip of asphalt from nowhere to nowhere, basically. Also, apparently they gave him a road that was not even well designed. And then the entire structure decided to award a contract on a road that will just be hanging. Because how could you say you are constructing a road from Karshi to Apo and you just do it halfway without even thinking and even awarding the linkage between Apo to this place we are here? If all the traffic is routed from Karshi and they decide to come here, for God's sake, how are they going to enter the city? So this is a big embarrassment and it's a shame to us, all of us.
This is the Takwashara Junction at the tail end of the Wasa district of the federal capital city, where the 9.8 kilometers of the road so far constructed ends. From this junction to the next settlement, which is Apo in Gudu district of the city, is the 4.2 kilometers that have not even been awarded for construction. The implication is that even if the road was to be completed today, motorists would not be able to use it as they cannot have access to the city center.
I know when you reach Wasa Junction, the end of the project, there is another 4.2 kilometer road along the aspect that has not been taken care of. FCD is considering awarding it now. It's part of the FCD contract that is going to process. The extension from Wasa up to towards Shoprite, you notice that there are some aspects of the road that is not asphalted. That one is being taken care of.
Driving from Apo to the Takwashara Junction, one can see a number of mass housing projects that should, on completion, accommodate thousands of families that have been abandoned for the obvious and simple reason that there is no road to the area. The non-completion of the road project is therefore not just about transportation, but housing and many more that can address a number of the development challenges facing the nation's capital. At the Karshi end of the road is also the problem of connecting the abandoned Apo Karshi road with the township roads in Karshi satellite town, with no clear point yet where the road will be so linked. This heap of chippings overlooks the valley that separates the Apo Karshi road from the Karshi satellite town, with the township roads here being a project handled by another construction company, ACC Nigeria, that has its own issues.
That if we are taking from Karshi up to somewhere in the middle of the road, and then Kafaka is taking from somewhere around the home.
That the person who gave you this information is not true. I know the job we are doing in Karshi.
Can you tell us this?
That's what I'm telling you. I said we are not part of that road.
Agreed.
Yes.
What I mean we are doing
there is that dam. Is that dam?
When I mean tell us, you tell us on camera that you are not part of this project.
Listen, go to let the person give you the information with the documents. You cannot just tell him story. Because if he give you the documents, if he's telling you the truth, let him give you the documents which indicate that contract is given to SEC. That is where you will believe him. I'm telling you because I'm working in the company, and I know if it is the job we are doing, there's no way I will tell you. That's why I quickly tell you, I say apart from that route, first of all, the contract they first get them is to provide the routes inside Kashi town, which they did. And then they give them the work to construct that dam. They started the dam before the election. They say they should stop, they stop the work. The foundation, it's just the foundation they started. It's like they just give them mobilization to fight. Apart from that, they have not seen any money again. They were hoping that after election they will continue with the job.
If you go there, you see how we park our this thing there. All the equipment that job is there. Because the hope was that they are going to work
for the dam now.
For the dam, yes. So up to now, no money, nothing. They have not started.
Like the FCT Minister Mohammed Bello, the constructor handling the Apokashi Road project, Kakata Group, would not speak to AIT about the project. The managing director of the construction company, Zibola Roberts, is the cousin of former President Goodluck Jonathan, who is on trial for a contract of $40 million from the Office of the National Security Advisor to another company, OnePlus Holdings Nigeria Limited, which he is the owner. Reports say the accounts of the companies owned by Azibola Robert, including the Kakata Group that is constructing the abandoned Apokashi Road, have been frozen by the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, the EFCC. And as we speak, nobody knows when this will end. What is, however, certain is the fact that only a little over 2.142 billion naira, representing 34% of the total contract sum of 6.3 billion naira, have been paid to the contractor till date. This leaves
too much for them, they cannot work. So now, when it stops raining, you will not see them. You see, so me, I don't really know what is going on. I don't know what is the problem. You see, but until when Buhari came up and they started using him as an excuse. So to me, it's not Buhari that is the problem. Because if they were serious, they would have been done by, with the road by now. This place is a major link from Kerishi, direct link to Apo. And with the kind of, you know, people feel like coming this way. Like this place now, people have bought so many plot of land. They are just waiting for the road to be completed. And before you know it, give this place 2-3 years to turn out to a better place. Because the water is not our problem. With this road, we know there are people that will come in, individual, they can drill borehole and start selling of water. We'll have good source of water. Private hospitals can come in. So the road is a major thing, and if the road can be completed, I think this place will become a better place to stay. When I keep challenging some of the workers, they do tell me, it's a SCDLA that gave the quotation. I said, come, it's not possible, you're not done anywhere. You are the one coming for job. You will give quotation. The only thing that SCDLA will do is to give an approval. So if you see some places that they are supposed to put bridge, they are putting cover, and the cover is not even much, very small. You see me? So I don't think there's any way they need to be proved. That's just the fact. I suspect some gain happening there.
Government be problem if not government fulfilling the vote. But in a doctor, but na still na him be chairman of this earth. But if you get problem for your body, if you carry him before you reach Kerishi, sometimes somebody go person go die because of rot. They finish the hospital, but the river open. Na him be doctor for here if you be doing one. If you think like a person, if you want to carry and go from this hospital, no hospital, before you reach Kerishi, person don't die.
The roads from Apo to Kerishi, which Akata company we are constructing, they have been there for a long time ago, since 2003. And we are starting the project, but to date, they can't complete it. And they stopped that work. Lastly, the work there is around September, where they stopped the work to date. All their company cars are there. All the engines are there. But nobody is not there, apart from the guard. So our requesting in Kerishi here, government should supervise that road, because day in, day out, when we listen to radio or television, they will be saying the work has been completed, which is not. As I'm talking now, if you can go to that road, you will discover that what I'm saying is true. So government should come over and take note of that so that they can, it's a problem already. Then they should find a solution to that problem. It's bringing blood, but you know, when the road is linking, we'll have some villages around the road and they are farmers. When they produce the goods, to bring it down here is difficult for them to bring it down. They don't take it to Wasa, Tabosa, instead of Karshi here. Because Karshi is nearby, then should take it to, but lack of that road make them to take their goods to the other places. That's why we are complaining about the road bitterly. Bitterly complaining. So far, government hasn't given the money. They should supervise the road so that we can see that the road has been worked tightly.
We have a good road that came from city to this very place. But the one that lead to bus out to the main place, which is from Karshi to Abaji Road, that they have started the road, but they just stop all of a sudden. Another one from Karshi to Apo Road, they have started it, but just stop all of a sudden. And that road help in many ways in this, even Abuja in general, because you go to Nyanya, coming back from Nyanya, from Asokoro, coming back to Nyanya, people, population are very plenty. But if this road from this road from Karshi to Apo is already is bust, you understand, people will be following this place. There will be lesser busy there at the Nyanya site, you understand. And it is the same thing again. If this one from Karshi go to Abaj, if it is, if it can go, government can make it, complete it, you understand, there will be bits. In fact, a relief for this very Abuja in the times of like a road conjunction.
What perhaps also needs to be proved is the compensation authorities of the FCT administration are said to have paid two original inhabitants of the territory who had to surrender their ancestral lands for the construction of the road. The unresolved issue of compensation will most likely rear its ugly head when those the government have also allocated plots of land along the whole stretch of the Apokarshi Road would want to take possession of their legitimate property and develop them when the road project is finally completed.
So far, I would say no, that there is no anything compensation. Yes. Anything regarding compensation, they will just be saying it's from FCD and that they have already been given this approval that they should come and just continue with their work. That's it.
Young woman, the same the corner, Kashu Maujan, the Rishidani, something that's what they would do. So that's okay, Chavishi. Yanzu haka a wajen babban kaunin da suna ta kokwar ba su yi a fasashewa gonar yana wajen.
And that's Straight Talk. Thanks for watching. I am TV. I will must say a big thank you to our partners, Media Dimensions, for their support. Goodbye from Abuja.
Personality, places, and events. It's all about personality interviews. We showcase and celebrate the social and corporate events.